Hi there, I'm Miranda Luna, and I'm the product manager for Windows Azure Mobile Services. Mobile Services makes it quick and easy to build dynamic and engaging mobile apps at scale. So what we do is we provide you with a little bit of structured storage through SQL database, an easy way to authenticate users via Facebook, Twitter, any sort of third-party identity provider you might be interested in, as well as send push notifications. We've always had support for building Windows Store and Windows Phone apps in C#. Today, I'm really excited to tell you about how we've made it even easier to design those connected mobile applications right from within Visual Studio. So today I'm going to walk you through connecting a new, brand new Windows Store project in Visual Studio to a backend hosted in Windows Azure and show you how easy it is to add push notifications and get up and running with data and a little bit of custom code through scripts. So let's get going. So we're just going to start by making a new project in Visual Studio to show you exactly what you can do now from within the Visual Studio experience. What's really great about this integration is that a lot of the work you used to have to do in the portal, like writing and editing your scripts, working with data, you can now do right from within Visual Studio IDE. So we're going to go to Visual C#, new Windows Store app, and let's call this Cloud VS. Now, while that's being created, this isn't actually connected to Windows Azure yet. What we're going to do as soon as this is created, so we're going to go over to our Server Explorer. You'll see that right here we just have the generic app template that comes with Visual Studio. It's a generic Windows Store template. If I hit F5, you're going to see the same experience you would with any other net new project, right? So it's completely blank, ready for you to work with it. So I'm going to quickly go back here. IntelliTrace is on, great. Let's shift F5. Stop running that, and then we're going to go over here and we are going to add connected service. This is what's going to connect it to Windows Azure with that SQL database in the cloud and also with those scripts and open up user authentication and push notifications. So if this was the first time I was doing this, as you might be able to tell, it's not my first rodeo, I would go to import subscriptions and I'd have to browse to find my Windows Azure profile. If I was doing this for the first time, I'd have to go to download subscription file, and it would take me here to the Windows Azure portal, which is where I'd be able to get that for my account. So if you have multiple subscriptions, you can definitely upload different subscription files. But today, since I'm just going to be using the one I already have here, I'm not going to go through all this again. So this is showing you my Windows Azure MSDN Visual Studio Ultimate subscription. These are mobile services I already have running today. As you can see, I was hanging out at TwilioCon recently. So this is the mobile services subscription I want to use, so I'm going to hit OK. And we boogie over here to the Server Explorer. It cooperates. Now we're going to see that under my mobile services, what the heck? So I skipped an important step after I was explaining how to do all the import subscription work. I need to create new service if I don't want to connect to an existing one. The great thing is with Visual Studio and Windows Azure is we obviously give you a lot of different options. So you can connect an existing app to a new mobile service. You can create a new mobile service and application at the same time. But today, since I started with a net new app that's not connected, I'm going to create a new service and map it to this. So I'm going to use the same name, Cloud VS. Hopefully no one's taking it. And you'll see that it's cloudvs.azuremobile.net. Mobile services is just a Node.js app that runs on top of Windows Azure websites and kind of makes it a lot easier to hit the certain mobile scenarios we've discussed so far. We're in West US. I already have a database over here. I'm going to use this one. Enter my password so that I'm not creating too many new things. If you wanted to create a new database or, you know, provision a new server, you could do all that right from within Visual Studio as long as you have network connectivity. And that's going to take a minute or so. Since we are creating a new mobile service, the great thing is that this is going to take no longer than it would if I was right in the Windows Azure portal and going through the new compute mobile services experience, which you might have seen in some other videos. So we're going to give this just a second to finish up. Great, so now what you can see here is that I've created that new service right from within Visual Studio. And if I went to the Windows Azure portal, which I might as well do just to show you, But if I go here back to where all my mobile services are, you'll see that if I refresh everything, let me just refresh here very quickly, you will see that new Cloud VS mobile service exists here, which is great. I didn't go to the portal. I didn't go through the create net new. From within Windows Azure, I didn't use the command line. I did it all from Visual Studio, and there's Cloud VS up and ready to go. Of course, we could have just trusted it from Visual Studio, but I like to prove that this is all live. All right, so Cloud VS, that's the mobile service we're going to use. And this is just connecting the mobile service to the app that we already have provisioned. So the first step was creating the mobile service. Now they have to run that connection. And you'll see right here that what it actually did was show your mobile services key, and then also that same URL I showed you, cloudvs.azuremobile.net. And that's what's going to mean that every time I import some new data, every time I run a new script, it's going to all be it's all going to get pushed right back up into the Windows Azure Cloud. Another really cool thing I can do is if I want to send push notifications, all I do is come in here and say add push notification. And I'm going to just follow this little wizard to, and it's basically going to associate this application, which I already have, net new project in Visual Studio with the mobile services backend, and it's going to acquire a channel URI and then connect it so that the push notification settings are already configured for you, given your Windows Store developer account. So this is just going to prompt me to sign into the Windows Store. If anyone's looking to spam me, you are welcome to right there. And it's going to send me a text message just to verify that it is in fact me who's creating this application in Visual Studio. I just received it, so I'm going to go ahead and enter it. And, you know, there's really nothing you can do with this passcode because it'll prompt me to create a new one if I need to again. So as you can see, all the applications have already set up with the WNS service, which is what Windows Store apps use for push notifications, are right here. If I wanted to reserve a new app name that's associated explicitly with this new service, I could. So I could call this Cloud VS, and as long as it's available, I can even reserve with WNS right from within Visual Studio, which is fantastic, and it's already configured. So I have that selected. I'm going to hit Next. And as you can see, I have that option to import subscriptions again, because if I didn't want to just go through the Add Connected Service flow, and I really just wanted to go straight to push notifications, maybe I didn't want to use the SQL database, maybe I didn't care about user authentication, maybe I'm not that interested in the scripts, I could go through that same flow I showed you with the provisioning your profile and importing subscriptions right through this Add Push Notification flow. But since I've already done that, I'm just going to go Cloud VS, and I'm going to finish. So as you can see, what's going on here is we're simply adding a reference to the mobile services SDK, bringing in the code files necessary to initialize the logic, which, you know, that custom logic is contained in mobile services script files. You know, as you can see right here, we opened right up into an insert script. So what that means is anytime I make an insert on a SQL database, which is associated with my mobile service, there's going to be whatever code I put here is going to execute. So what I'd like to show you today is to leave this Start from Scratch app here and pull open a mobile services, just the starter project that you get with mobile services. It's a to-do app, so I'm just going to quickly open that up. The reason I'm going to use this is because I don't want to start a new project and write a to-do app right now. We're trying to keep these videos digestible. So as soon as this opens, I'm going to hit F5, show you what it looks like. And since this is an app I actually grabbed from the portal, it's already connected to a mobile service called TwilioCon 2K13. So now I've opened my TwilioCon 2K13 app right here in Visual Studio. You know, if I open my app.xaml file, you'll see this is where I have that connection to mobile services. This app is going to have a different URL than obviously Cloud VS that we created live today, and the connection string is already going to be pre-provisioned. So what I'm going to do is F5 and just show you what this looks like. So as you can see, when I start the app, if I add a to-do item like head to building 127 where I'm recording this today and hit save, what it's going to do is send a post right to my Windows Azure SQL database, and this is going to be stored in there. And the way we have it provisioned right now, that there's a field for text, and then there's a boolean for completed or not, and that's going to be false right now. If I hit this button, it's going to be true. So what I'm going to show you is just how cool it is that you can edit the data, edit the scripts that run on the CRUD operations on a SQL database right from within Visual Studio. So if I go over to my Server Explorer, you'll see that. My Windows Azure Mobile Service is right here. And the SQL database I associated with it is right there as well. So I'm using TwilioCon 2K13. And there's going to be a database associated with that too. So this is that table that we're working with, to-do item, and I asked it to refresh. But if you go right here and to... Let me just show you the Windows Azure portal really quick so you know that I'm not lying, that we just added that data. So we go to to-do item, to that table we created right from within Visual Studio, right there, head to building 127. Complete, the Boolean is set to false. So what we're going to do is on the insert script, we're just going to add a really short line of code, and what it's going to do is add a timestamp every time we add a new to-do item. And it's going to do that using dynamic schema, which is a feature in mobile services that you're welcome to leave on during development so that you can create a schema for your database dynamically. You don't have to, you know, explicitly set anything. And then once you go to production, you can just flip it off. So let's go over here to the insert script. Okay, so on insert, I'm going to say new or item.created equals new date. And this is all in JavaScript, even though you're within Visual Studio. Currently, mobile services only supports JavaScript on the server, but we'll be adding support for C# soon, and then that experience will be baked right into Visual Studio as well. So if I save this, and now I hit F5, say new to-do item, let's say grab lunch at the Commons. I'm giving you guys the tour of the Redmond campus today. You'll see head to building 127 is still there. Now I've added grab lunch at the Commons with a little post. I'm going to mark that as completed so that when we go back over to the Windows Azure portal, you'll see what exactly we just did from within Visual Studio. So let's stop this really quickly. Head over to Windows Azure portal. And if I refresh this, what's going to be really cool is from right within Visual Studio, not only did we add a new column called created, and that's where that item.created equals new date came in. It just put a little timestamp in UTC time. But we also went ahead and marked head to building 127 in the complete column as true, and that updated right there, all from within our experience in Visual Studio. Now you can, you know, completely edit and debug scripts from within Visual Studio. You can't actually browse the data. You do need to head to the Windows Azure portal for that. But pretty much anything else you can do from within Visual Studio, including opening up the Windows Azure portal, you know, adding those profiles that we talked about, and making sure that all your projects align to the right subscription. So it's pretty cool. We're really excited about it, and we're really, really excited to continue to improve the experience for Visual Studio developers using Windows Azure to build connected applications. I hope that you found that useful. Now you're off and running building connected mobile applications using Visual Studio and Windows Azure. If you're looking for more information, head to www.windowsazure.com/mobile and you'll find everything you need. Thank you for your time.